Do you have that new bearing?
Yes, but there's something I can't quite... Wow!
What happened? What is it?
I'm getting a reading 10 times normal. Bearing 12804. Of course, we're in line with the Culver Atomic Centre.
At the center, the main gates had been smashed in. Captain Okra was on the scene.
Captain Black crashed the gates with the SPV. The whole center is completely surrounded. He's in here, all right.
But we don't know his exact position.
Thank you, Captain Okra. Stand by for further orders.
Why go back to the atomic center, sir?
If you want to hide an apple tree, you put it in an orchard. Captain Black must have known he was radioactive, so he returns to the atomic center.
Where there is enough free radiation to make him undetectable.
Exactly. Well, Lieutenant, I think we'll play a waiting game.
As night fell once more, we had all assembled at the center.
Are we going to just sit here and look at each other?
It's a pretty big plant. He could be anywhere.
Well, let's get in there and find him.
Our orders are to wait.
What about Symphony?
Symphony? I just hope she's all right.
How long do you intend to keep me here? It's only a matter of time. The place is surrounded. What are you doing? No. No, you can't do it.
Opening the door to a radiation chamber, Captain Black savagely pushed Symphony inside, and she fell to the floor. Black then sealed the entrance.
I'm going in.
No, Captain Blue. We wait.
I am sorry, Symphony Angel, but you leave me no choice.
That voice... You'll never get away with this.
Prepare to die. The radiation will kill you in 3 minutes.
The chamber began to glow with a pulsating light. Inside, Symphony was being bombarded with radioactive energy. Now, Captain Black increased the level. After a few more seconds, Symphony began to feel faint, the intense radiation burning deep into her body. Then, just as she thought that she was finished, Captain Black shut off the machine.
The Mysterons also have compassion. I am going to give you one chance.
Colonel, the SPV has crashed the gates.
Right. Make certain Captain Black is in it, and don't lose him.
Yes, I've got a positive reading.
It's him, all right.
He's heading south.
Right. He won't get far. There's a roadblock half a mile down the road. Come on.
As the SPV sped out of the atomic center and toward the roadblock, Captain Scarlet and I were in hot pursuit in our saloon. As the SPV reached the blockade, it careered off the road and crashed straight into a tree. We had Captain Black cold, or had we?
Captain Black, you are completely surrounded. Come out with your hands up. All right, we're coming in.
But inside the SPV, a surprise awaited us.
Symphony.
How are you feeling, Symphony?
She's all right, Colonel. Just badly shaken.
I'm sorry, sir. I feel I let you down.
All right, Symphony. But remember, initiative should never clash with discipline.
Yes, sir.
The Mysterons wage a war of nerves. Captain Black gave you a chance to escape, and you took it.
He subjected you to radiation, knowing we would pick it up, Think it was him in the SPV and leave the gate unguarded.
He even went through a cleansing unit before he left to get rid of his own radiation.
Well, we've been tricked. But we've learned a lot. The Mysterons are capable of making mistakes. Let us take consolation from this in the continuing fight. Aye, that's all.
Symphony?
What is it?
One thing puzzles me. Why didn't you stop the SPV just outside the gates?
Don't tell anyone, Lieutenant, but that's the first time I've ever driven an SPV.
Captain Scarlet! Scarlet.